Hi, it's time for a little Excel formulas and functions workout. We're going to take a look at how to do lookup on a list of comma-separated values from a single cell. So let me explain what we want to achieve with this example. Here we have a column. Each cell in the column is a list of comma-separated values. Not a clean list. There's a bunch of spaces in there. What I would like to do, I would like to look up each one of those values in this table array, and I would like to create a cell with the list of group names instead. So we have group numbers and group names. And I am going to use VLOOKUP for that. So how shall we approach this? Well, first we need to take each one of these cells and we need to convert those values into a list. And for that, there's a function called textSplit, right? So we use textSplit. And what text are we going to split? We're going to split this value in the cell, which is a comma separated values. Column delimiter, I am going to put another comma. I'm going to skip that. That will split everything into rows instead of into columns. And for the row delimiter, I'm going to specify comma inside double quotes. And now I got these values as a dynamic array. Right, so this is a dynamic array. I'm going to put formula text, and that way you can see the formula. So we are splitting this text by comma, by the separator comma, into a dynamic array. But we also get a bunch of spaces. You see it's all truncated like that. In order to fix that, we're going to add trim to the text split. And then I get a nice split list of values in a column. Now, VLOOKUP, vertical lookup, can look up in a column, be it a dynamic array or a regular column. So I can try to use VLOOKUP now, and I can look up the value. But of course, if I want to look up the entire dynamic array, every value in the dynamic array, I need to reference it with a hashtag. Right? So D4 is the cell where the dynamic array begins. And I'm going to look up that value inside of this table array. In the leftmost column with the VLOOKUP, I'm going to hit the F4 key to toggle references so that I have the dollar signs, absolute references. And the column index number is 2. And for the range lookup, I would like the exact match, so the false argument. Now, when I try that, it's not working. You see that it can't find the value. Like NA means that this value is not available in the lookup table array. Now, the reason for that is these are treated as text and these are actually numbers. So you cannot find the text in the list of numbers. But of course, we can fix that if we add another function here called number value, which will return a number that is like text into, it will convert it into a number. So now I have 1, 2, 3, 9. Right, and I have the corresponding looked up value. So I achieve what I want, but I want to put them into a single cell. So for that, we have another function called textJoin. I'm going to use textJoin, and the delimiter that I'm going to be using is going to be comma space inside double quotes. I want to separate all of these bad cat mad get with comma space. And comma, I would like to, well, I'll ignore empty cells, even though I don't think it matters in this case, but I will ignore them because, what I would like to work on, I would like to work on this dynamic array, which is starts in E4, and I'm going to put the hashtag. And now I got what I wanted, right? So these values are first split into separate cells in a dynamic array, technically, and then each one of them is looked up here and returned as the result, and then everything is combined together. I'm going to copy the formula text so that you can observe the formula. There's a bit of a caveat here. What if I have something that is not available on my lookup list? Like if I put 20, you see that 20 is not available. I cannot find 20. Well, I get an error here, and the error actually kills everything else after the error. You see the entire text join returns an error. So in order for this to work properly, what I need to do, I need to maybe wrap up VLOOKUP into the IfError function. So I want to replace the error with some text value, some indication that it's an error, but it's not a real error type. So I'm going to use IfError. Then what do I want? I want, well, maybe something like in parentheses NA text, and I need to unquote, double quote. So now you see that the error is actually replaced with the text value, and it's working properly. And this is it. All I need to do now is to combine all of those calculations into this one formula. So I'm going to double click and select all of these, Control C, Escape, and I'm going to paste that instead of the reference D4. I'm going to replace the reference D4 with that, Control V, Enter. Now I'm going to take all of this and no equal sign, Control C, copy, Escape, and I'm going to feed it instead of the E4 reference, Control V, press Enter. So this is now a standalone formula. It's not dependent on any of these intermediary steps. And I can copy it down, and you see that it is actually working properly on each one of these. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to click and drag and move it into column C. That's where I wanted it, to place it. Right, so now I have my results. And of course, the results are not dependent on the initial, you know, on any of these. I can clear that. And here you go. So we're looking up each one of the comma-separated values inside of this table array, and we are returning comma-separated values of the group names of the results. It worked. I'll see you in the next one.